Here's something I get asked a lot. Should dogs eat broccoli? Well, my answer is only every dog in the world should eat broccoli and other cruciferous veggies every single day. If you worry about your dog's risk of cancer, then you'll want to watch this video and find out how foods like broccoli can fight tumors and chronic disease. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. So a few years back, researchers at Purdue University found that dogs that ate veggies 3 times a week or more had a whopping 90% decrease in cancer risk. So that's certainly reason enough to feed your dog veggies. But there's something in cruciferous veggies in particular that makes them the king of all the other veggies. So what are cruciferous veggies? Well, these are members of the cabbage family, and it includes broccoli, Brussels sprouts, kale, cauliflower, and cabbage, of course. Now, they're rich in vitamins and minerals, but their biggest claim to fame is a little compound called sulforaphane. This is what makes cruciferous veggies a potent enemy of cancer cells. Now, sulforaphane has a unique ability to activate something called the NRF2 pathway. And this pathway turns inflammation off in your dog. Now, that probably sounds simple and not all that exciting, but here's the thing you have to remember. Virtually every chronic disease in the body is caused by chronic inflammation. Heart disease, liver failure, kidney failure, pancreatitis, cancer, joint disease, they're really all the same disease. They're only different because the body-wide inflammation has affected one organ more noticeably than the rest. So keeping inflammation down in your dog is the single most important thing that you can do for his health. Let me say that again because it's really important. Inflammation is the enemy of old age. So there are 3 really critical ways that sulforaphane can help your dog fight dangerous inflammation. First, it fights cancer. And it does this in several ways, but mainly by inhibiting enzymes that cause defects in your dog's DNA and causes tumors to grow and spread. And researchers actually found this to be true in dogs. They gave them broccoli sprout powder and saw a reduction in this enzyme activity. And I'll have links to the studies in the description below in case you're interested. And as always, if you have any questions, just ask in the comments and I'll try to answer them all. Now, the second way that sulforaphane can help reduce your dog's risk of cancer and other disease is by detoxifying the liver. Your dog's liver helps exit inflammatory toxins from his body, things like pesticides, chemicals, and molds. Well, sulforaphane activates phase 2 liver detoxification, which makes toxins water-soluble so that they can just be squirted out with the urine. Plus, it activates enzymes that protect your dog's DNA from damage from any toxins the liver is pulling out of the body. And finally, sulforaphane is a really potent antioxidant. Most dogs don't have enough antioxidants to protect them, and when they don't, then dangerous free radicals build up in the body and damage the cell membranes and organs. This causes premature aging and disease, even in young dogs. Now, I mentioned earlier that sulforaphane activates the anti-inflammatory NRF2 pathway. When this happens, it then activates important antioxidant enzymes all through your dog's body, which cleans up those harmful free radicals before they get out of control and damage the organs that they live in. And just like the antioxidants from blueberries, sulforaphane can cross the blood-brain barrier and increase antioxidant activity in the brain, and of course in the liver too. And here's a bonus benefit. Sulforaphane builds healthy guts by protecting against harmful bacteria that can cause gut inflammation, ulcers, and digestive cancers. But here's the thing. Sulforaphane only stays in your dog for about 24 hours, so you need to feed it daily to keep inflammation down. Okay, so hopefully I've convinced you to feed your dog cruciferous veggies every day. But not all cruciferous veggies contain the same amount of sulforaphane. The best source is broccoli, but not all dogs love broccoli, and it can kind of make dogs fart. So here's a little known secret. Pound for pound, sprouts contain a lot more sulforaphane than adult plants. So the number one source of sulforaphane and the best activator of NRF2 next to expensive ozone therapy is broccoli sprouts. They contain nearly 100 times more sulforaphane than broccoli does. In fact, most of the studies that I cited use broccoli sprouts for this reason. So let's get to the meat of the matter. How much should you give your dog? Well, I did a little bit of math to make sure that your dog gets a therapeutic dose of sulforaphane, which is about 0.1 to 0.5 milligrams per kilogram of body weight. So that means that a large-sized dog would need about half a cup daily. And dogs are less likely to get farty with sprouts, so that's another bonus. Now, if you're feeding broccoli or other cruciferous veggies, you either need to feed them raw and mulched or lightly steam them for no more than 3 minutes and below 155 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's because heat destroys the enzyme that activates sulforaphane. That means that frozen veggies won't work all that well because they're often blanched before they're frozen. Now, you can safely add broccoli or sprouts as about 5 to 10% of your dog's diet every day, and research shows that you should. The more you feed, the lower the risk of cancer and chronic inflammation. Now, don't forget to leave your comments or questions below and check out the resources for links and other information. And if you like this video, please make sure that you like it, share it, and tell people about it. Thanks for watching.